The call was made by Nuwal Warira, the Chief Executive Officer of Atomic Energy Council, while appearing before Parliament's Defence and Internal Affairs Committee that is scrutinising the Explosive Bill 2023 that is seeking to repeal Explosive Act Cap 288 that was first enacted in 1936. The new amendments intended to update the 87-year-old law with developments in technology in the use, storage, manufacture of explosives and misuse of explosives.
As we do our transmission lines, sometimes you encounter a hard surface down and you need to seek to use an explosive to blast either rock that is underground where positioning, for example, an electric pylon.
While defending his proposal, Warira argued that explosives with radioactive materials can disperse them to the environment, hence causing significant contamination and exposure of the public to ionizing radiation through different exposure pathways, which may lead to loss of lives.
Chair, it's known that these materials can be used in radiological dispersive devices, as well as in radiological improvised devices. So we must specifically prohibit the use of these materials.
However, committee members expressed concerns with gaps in management of radioactive waste, especially in hospitals, which exposes Ugandans to danger.
But that question the chair has already asked, because you would be having facilities, for example, at the border posts where goods are coming in, so that you check whether there are some more radioactive materials in the goods.
The council also proposed to have clause 49 of the Explosives Bill 2023 amended to provide for stringent offences and penalties for convicts involved in the use of radiology dispersive devices and radiological improvised devices illegally.
Chair,
yes.
They are saying that sections should specify escalated punishments for convicts involved in the use of RDDs and RIDs. And I wanted to get the opinion on what penalty they would propose.
The council also proposes to have provision for emergency response to explosive emergencies for anyone to be licensed to operate explosives like fireworks.
Our observation is that this bill should include or should have a section on response to explosive emergencies.
Clause 16.4 of the bill provides for a fine of 10 billion shillings or life imprisonment for a person who manufactures any category of explosives without license, while clause 31 and 35 is prohibiting the importation, exportation and blasting of explosives without the requisite certificates issued by the chief explosives inspector, and the offenders attract a fine of 10 billion shillings or imprisonment for a term not exceeding 10 years or both. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.